David Shakur Stevenson, I'll quote him. He said, "David Benavidez is a bad motherfucker," and that he thinks you're the toughest fight out there for Canelo. What do you think of his fight with Oscar Valdez? Well, like, what do you have to say about you?
First of all, you know, I just feel very honored. You know, from getting a compliment like that from an Olympian and silver medalist. You know, he's a great fighter. I feel like he's going to be unified champion in multiple divisions one day. So I feel very, very motivated by just hearing him say that. And I feel the same way about him. I mean, he's a great fighter. He's probably one of the best 130-pounders in the world today. And I feel like he's going to go in there and he's going to beat Valdez no problem. I think it's going to be very difficult for Valdez to even catch him or, you know, to catch Stevenson's counters. You know, and Stevenson, he's a bad motherfucker as well. So, you know, I'm very happy to hear that.
Last one, guys.
And with Joe Smith and Better, do you have any thoughts on that? And would your speed be too much for either one of them, regardless?
That's a great fight. That's one of the fights I'm most excited about this year, you know, just to watch as a fan. I feel like, to be honest, I feel the experience is on Joe Smith's side because he's fought Bernard Hopkins. He's fought Dimitri Bivol. He's fought, what's his name, Barrera, Sullivan Barrera. You know, he's fought a lot of good guys. And then he hits hard, too. So, you know, I feel like they're both motivated. I mean, it's just a different level. You know, they're very motivated to become unified 175 champion, too. But, you know, just the way I was seeing Burnaby fight when he fought that one dude.
Marcus Brown.
You know, Alexander
Bosnick.
And I've sparred Alexander Bosnick, too, and I've heard him. So, I mean, just seeing that he had a success with Berdabia makes me think, what if I go up there? Now I'm sure I could touch, you know, Berdabia for Joe Smith, you know, because I have the speed and I have the power. And I think going up to 175, I'll be even faster and even stronger.
And then, obviously, he's been dropped before. So, has that kind of, like, put an idea, like, oh, if Callum Johnson dropped him, like, I could definitely drop him or hurt him?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like I could hurt anybody I put my hands on, you know, anybody. But, like, with knockdowns like that, I don't think, oh, yeah, he has a weak chin, this and that. Because this is a flash knockdown, to be honest with you.
That wasn't his first knockdown, though.
That wasn't his first.
No, he got dropped earlier in his career. I can't.
Okay, well, then maybe he has a, you know, I mean, if I catch anybody with the right shot, I can drop anybody. But, like I said, yeah, I don't think about that. I think about, you know, just being the best version of myself, worrying about speed, combinations, power shots, body shots. And that way, I could, you know, when I'm 100% and I could see how I'm doing, then I could look at a fight and see what I could put in and or what the type of combinations I could use.
Thanks, David. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, David.